handful tin straight into my pocket. That will be an extra wage if I go and sell it. Every village needs a new bell. Now and then, this was also the case in a place called Nideggen. The order for a new bell, brand new bell up here, was given to bell founder Christopher of Trier. But the master was plagued by gout, could not work himself, so his journeyman prepared the bronze for the bell. 78 parts of copper, 22 of tin, a little silver, and the bell will ring. But the journeyman thought, what's the point of that? Doesn't matter if you take a little more or little less. When everything has melted, you can see it anyway. So he made his pockets full, full of shiny metal. Silver and a handful tin straight into my pocket. That will be an extra wage if I go and sell it. They called the bell, Virgin Mary. The whole village gathered when they hung her in the belfry, to see and to hear how she shines and sings. The master pulled the bell rope, but the bell didn't ring. Something is not right here, although it swings. A church bell should not rattle, it should sing. Maybe I'm not strong enough, you try it, journeyman. He pulled as hard as he could until suddenly something broke. The big heavy bell clapper, oh, it came down, killed the journeyman. And when he fell on the ground, a lot of silver coins rolled out of his pocket, and everyone knew right well what shameless game he had played. A lot of silver coins rolled out of his pocket. Everyone knew right well